Shortly after 6 a.m. at the Lee Funeral Home in Nairobi, family, friends and Kenyans gathered. The D-Day had dawned. Moi's body will be leaving the capital Nairobi for his Sacho home. The military will load his coffin into a waiting black hearse, his coffin draped in the Kenyan flag, typical of a state funeral. The hearse carrying his remains will slide onto Bagadhi Road at 7 a.m., temporarily halting traffic to pave way for the funeral procession. 20 minutes later, the procession will enter Wilson Airport. The coffin was removed from the hearse and loaded into a waiting M71 military chopper. Baringo Senator Gideon Moi entered the chopper to travel with the body of his late father.
When you go to Wilson and fly off, I said I will never ever enter that M1, M11, it's the M11 helicopter. I said unless I'm dead or alive, I'm not entering that. Today I entered it. Nasuku, I had no choice. That excellent pilots, excellent service. The Defense Forces, the Air Force are the ones who brought Mze with their pallbearers, all of them here, 23 of us, and I was the only civilian there.
At 7:45 a.m., the chopper ferrying the remains of the late retired president took to the skies, flying over Nairobi for the final time. 1 hour later, at 8:45 a.m., the chopper landed at Kabarak airstrip. The military receiving his remains. His casket was loaded onto a gun carriage and escorted to Kabarak University grounds. The road to Kabarak University grounds well manicured with trees on both sides. Shortly before 9:30 a.m., his body arrived at the university grounds for a final service. This marked the end of his journey from Nairobi to Kabarak University grounds, which is in his home county of Nakuru.